But there's a second piece to this, and that goes to our own leadership and engagement, because here's what we know. If we are not engaged, if we are not leading, then one of two things happens. Either someone else is, and probably not in ways that advance our interests and values. And what's happened in recent years is increasingly that someone else has been China. As we step back, they've stepped in, and that is not in our interest. And we see that in international organization after international organization, where the day in, day out work of international relations gets done, where lots of rules and norms and standards that actually govern our lives in ways that most people don't even see, but feel, takes place. So we're very much stepped in there. Across the board, this engagement is important because, again, if we're not doing it, someone else maybe, or maybe no one is, and that usually creates a vacuum into which bad things flow before good things do. So the approach that we've taken across the board is directly applicable to how we're trying to deal effectively with China. And again, that involves shoring up alliances, partnerships, having a common approach, and making sure that the United States itself is once again engaged, once again at the table. You know the old expression, if you're not at the table, you'll probably be on the menu. We are, and we'll remain at the table.
Secretary Blinken, there is a feeling that it's more than a feeling. It's what we see on happening on the ground, that the U.S.-China tensions are leading to greater fragmentation, and that you're almost competing for, you know, alliances. Who's our ally? And we see this within the UN and various UN institutions, but we just see it all around the globe. To what extent do you feel that you are challenged in your travels around the world on the fundamental questions?
Well, first, it's wonderful to be with my friends, wonderful to be back in Munich at the Security Conference, known among all of us as speed dating for diplomats. But we've done a couple of things, and I'll come quickly to your question. From the start of this administration, we've made an investment, a reinvestment, in our alliances, in our partnerships, and in the multilateral system. We've reinvested, we've reengaged, we've tried to rejuvenate, we've even reimagined. And the reason for that is simple. It's because it's in our interest to do it. Not a single one of the challenges that we have to face and that are so important to the interests of the American people can we effectively deal with alone, as powerful and as resourceful as we are. And so across the board, we've seen our comparative advantage as having a strong network of voluntary alliances, voluntary partnerships, and if you're not at the table in the international system, you're going to be on the menu. So it was very important for us to re-engage multilaterally, and we've done that.